everyone, this is Yashni, and this year I have secured 57th rank in civil service examination. And these are my last minute tips for prelims examination, as it is hardly 10-12 days away. And my credibility for this video: my first attempt I failed prelims, and in the next attempt I scored 161 marks in prelims paper 1. So here are my few last minute tips for prelims. So I am dividing this into two parts. First, what we can do now before the prelims, and second part, what we can plan to do in the examination hall. So before the prelims, at the moment, the first and very important thing is, please be calm. Do not panic. You would yourself be surprised how much wonders your mind can do if it is free and it can analyze freely. So its efficiency will also increase and you'll not make silly mistakes. So it's very important, be calm. If you have not studied whatever you had planned to, also be confident on whatever you have studied and do not panic now. Second thing would be revision. Revision is something that I want to stress upon the most. It is very important that you consolidate whatever you know. Whatever you know, revise it so that you can remember the minutest detail of it. UPSC has a knack for answering such questions with minute details, right? Which article or salary, allowance, this of High Court judge or Supreme Court judge, which one is charged on the consolidated fund. So such minute details, like only salary but not allowance, or only office and not pension. So these things, it would come, these minute details will come only through multiple revisions. So revise, keep revising. My advice would be, do not read anything new at the point. It would only lead to confusion. Okay, so revise theory. Certain parts of the syllabus, it's static in nature, right? Polity, history, geography, these are static. So revise theory. Current affair booklets, if you have been reading, revise current affair booklets, all the government schemes, important news, revise them again, at least 1 year's current affairs. And question papers also, if you, I think now it is high time that we can stop practicing more and more new question paper. There are so many question papers and resources available in the market, it's by no way you would be able to finish all of them. So whatever you have read until now, revise them. Especially those mock answers, mock questions where you did not know the answer to, or you could not solve it, revise those questions also. Okay, so now is the time to revise and consolidate your learning. So for this, now that we have very less time left, it's very important to schedule your time also. So that is the third thing, scheduling or time management. Okay, now we cannot waste time on anything basically. So do schedule your preparation, like last few days, how do you utilize it to the maximum, to the fullest. For example, what I used to do is, last 10 days of the exam, I would have a schedule like this. For example, if on the 10th day exam is there, prelims is there, so 9th day I would keep it as a buffer. Okay, 8th day I would read history. 7th and 8th day I would read history, because these small points I need to remember, so I would do it at the end. So history I would do on the 7th and 8th day. Just before that, 3 days I would do a polity, because polity again requires remembering constitutional amendments and articles and all those things. So first day, for example, I would keep geography or economics, because I felt fairly confident in that. So this was what I did. This was my schedule of preparation the last 10 days. You know your strengths better and you schedule it according to your requirements. Okay. And the last day, I used to keep it as buffer, because any day I'm having a spillover, I could not finish the intended portions on, for example, today. So that doesn't affect my whole plan, right? So I always have this buffer for this to fall back on. Okay. And these are pandemic times. So one very important thing you should keep in mind is avoid unnecessary exposure or crowd at the moment. Eat healthy. Avoid unnecessary exposure. We don't want to miss the exam for any untoward reason, right? So keep yourself safe and healthy. And if you have not changed your sleep cycle yet, if you are one of those night owls and you have not changed your sleep cycle, please do it. It had cost me one attempt. I could not keep myself awake during that time because that was my sleeping time. So try to change your sleep cycle. Good 8 hours sleep if you have not done, and try to wake up before 8, 7, 8, just as per the prelims timetable. Okay, and coming to the next point, one very important thing is to have a plan ready. You would have solved many mocks by now, and if not, also you should you might have an idea how are you going to approach the exam. So one important thing is keep the plan ready. So what I mean by that will come. I'll explain now. So this is what we could do in the 10 days prior to the prelims exam. So what we could do in the prelims hall is, one, as I said, keep the plan ready. What was my plan, for example? Like, that plan is what, it's not a strategy as such, but it is now. You can like, when I was doing, it was not a strategy, but now that I am a success, like, it became a strategy. You can find your own like that. So the plan, keep the plan ready. Okay, what I used to do, what I had planned was, every 30 minutes, I'll attempt 30 questions, so that like in 1.5 hours, I can attempt all the 100 questions. I can have a look at all the 100 questions. Okay, so like that, how you would manage your time, keep a plan ready, how you are planning to go about the paper. And for example, tough questions, difficult questions, if there were, I would mark them, and I first finish all the questions that I know, and then come back to the difficult questions at the end. Okay, so like that, you also think how you would go about. And one important thing to note here is, do not keep too little a time to mark the bubbles, like only last 10 minutes, last 15 minutes. If you do like that, then you might not be able to circle all the bubbles. That is such a waste of time. Or if you manage to do also, you might end up making mistakes in the bubble. So always keep adequate time for marking the bubble also. And if you do not know answer to a question very well, or if you are having confusion in one question, do not waste too much time on that. See, 30 minutes, 30 questions, you can have only 1 minute per question, right, on an average. So instead of wasting 10 minutes on a question, 2 marks, you can do like 5 more questions, 10 more questions, like 10, 20 marks. So don't compromise on that, like proportionately allocate time. So first do all the questions that you know, and then you come back to the difficult part. So the second thing is like, expect the unexpected. Okay, in prelims exam, don't go into the exam thinking that I'll know answer to every question. And if you don't know answer to every question, don't get panicky or don't get scared. It's perfectly normal. Okay, so in any prelims paper, I think there will be at least 30-40 questions which nobody would be knowing the answers to, like 100%. So here what we can do is, one thing is, keep your theory pakka, like keep your theory ready, because these are the questions that everybody would be, like almost everybody, like would be doing it correctly. Everybody as in the would be, like those who would be going forward. So almost everybody will be doing this correctly, the static part, the theoretical part. So you don't lag behind on that. Keep this firm. And on the unconventional part, which are difficult questions, so there you can eliminate a lot by using common sense also. I am not in support of like blind guesses, but logical deductions, yes, you can arrive at. For example, I would like to substantiate that by an example. Last year one question was there, okay, on AIB, so Asian Infrastructure Bank. So we know that AIB is a Chinese-led initiative, right? So the question had 3 statements, and based on that, options 1 and 2 or 2 or 3, like that, options were there. So we know that AIB is a Chinese-led bank. So even if you do not know all the 3 statements, one statement was there, that India is the largest shareholder in AIB. So even if you don't know the other 3 statements, you know that this statement is wrong for sure, right? India cannot be the largest shareholder in AIB. It's a Chinese-led initiative. So that statement is gone for sure. So if that one statement is gone, whatever like option that doesn't contain that statement, you can have a like, you can eliminate those questions, those statements, those options. So in my opinion, if you have a 50-50 chance, go ahead. Okay, 50-50 chance is a good enough risk. I do not support like blind guesses, like where your chance of success is only 25% and like 3/4 chance of failure. So such logical guesses, you can Go ahead. I would like to give one more example. Another question was there on RBI. I felt it was a very difficult and complex question. Okay, I was not even able to comprehend the options there. But then one option, it was on storage of payment related data. It had been in news. So payment storage of payment related data. But one option was systems should be owned and operated by public sector entities. Okay, that RBI is mandated, the system should be owned and operated by public sector entities. So this again, we can think that RBI will not issue such a directive, right? Not in post-liberalization India. We are having private telecom companies, private financial fintech apps, fintech companies. So RBI will not mandate that systems are owned and operated by TSE, public sector entities. So if you again eliminate those questions, it was very easy to arrive at the answer, the correct option. So the point I'm trying to make here is the easy questions, generally the static theoretical questions, be very thorough with that, because that will come through multiple revision of your static parts, okay, like history and all those things, geography, which C's are there, that order and all those things. So these static parts, consolidate that and be strong in that. And unconventional questions, do not be scared, do not worry. You can always arrive at the answer by elimination, okay? And little bit of logical reasoning. You already have immense information with you. You just need to little bit use it, okay? And in the examination hall, one very important tip is like read the questions carefully. There is no alternative to it. Read the questions very carefully. For example, the first thing that I used to do when reading a question was I would first check and encircle like whether what is it asking. If it is asking for incorrect option, first you circle that incorrect word. Or if it is asking for a false option, first you encircle that false word so that you don't make any mistakes there. So read the question carefully, see if it is asking incorrect or false options, and then beware of that option. Okay, none of the above option. That is very tricky option. There like. Absolutely sure the technique might fail there, so beware of that none of the above option. And other than that, I think you should do well, read questions carefully, and be calm, do not be anxious or frightened. Everybody is on the same boat, okay? And for the CSAT part, so as I said, keep a plan ready. So I had an idea for like CSAT part also. For example, for paper one, I had kept time for revisiting and doing the difficult questions like that. But for CSAT, I did not keep time for revisiting. I would go in one go only, and after every two pages solving, I would mark the bubble and go forward. But also, it's not important that you solve each and every maths question. It is the qualifying paper. So adequate number of questions only we should do. So do not waste time on solving like finding answer to each difficult question. So that would be my final advice at the moment. Revise, be calm, and keep yourself healthy. Have a schedule, time schedule, so that you don't waste any time. And in the examination hall, again, have a plan of action ready, what you are planning to do. Stick to the time limit. Do not give disproportionate time on any subject or any question. Expect the unexpected and be confident. You already have a plethora of knowledge and like nothing else is required. You already have all the knowledge, only its application is required, okay? So even if unexpected questions are there, do not be scared. And if you are watching this video now and you are having a prelims exam, now the time is up, break time is up. Please go back to your studies. This is it. All the very best to anyone watching this. Thank you. Sir?
Yeah. Good. Great video, Rashni. Thank you so much. I'll discuss what title we can give for this video, like some last minute tips or something. We'll draft a title and I'll share that with you. We'll upload this pretty soon itself.
Achha, sir, I forgot to mention the blog thing. I have mentioned like that answer writing thing. No, you can just give it in the description.
Sure. We'll put that in both the descriptions, in success stories as well as this tips video. We'll add the blog details also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you so much, Yashmi. Thank you so much. I'll call you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.